Welcome to the lab on tic-tac-toe. You have learned a tremendous amount this semester, and this lab is going to tie together everything that you have learned. You're going to be using algorithms and pseudocode and functions and abstraction and variables and control and sensing. You're going to put that all together into one program to have fun playing tic-tac-toe. This is the largest lab that you will have done all semester, but you can do it. I promise you can. It will be worth it, and it'll be a lot of fun, and you will learn a lot. You're going to write a tic-tac-toe player from scratch, so that means you're going to write the computer opponent, you're going to write the interface for the human to play against the computer opponent. Now I want you to remember, it doesn't need to be beautiful, it just needs to be able to play. And remember one other key thing, it does not need to be optimal. I ask you to write something that is not just a random player, but it needs to be something that the computer and the human can have fun playing with each other, but it doesn't need to be optimal. Since this is the largest lab of the semester, I'm sure you're going to have a lot of questions, and I'm sure that we can help you on the discussion board or through email if you need it, but I also want you to know that there is going to be a lot of help through the different videos that we've had. We talked about tic-tac-toe in the video on pseudocode, and also this is a project that the class that is very similar to ours that is held at Berkeley does as well, and I have linked into the web pages that they have up there for help. Let me give you a quick demo of my tic-tac-toe player. When I click the flag, it's going to redraw the board from scratch. Well, first it's going to ask me, do you want to be X or do you want to be O? And you can choose whichever you want to be. I'll be X for now. So you'll notice I'm entering it down there at the bottom of the screen. It's going to draw the board, and now it wants to know what my move is. Now I haven't implemented the part of the user interface where you could actually click on the different parts of the screen, and so instead I'm using the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And I say in the lab write-up that you could use this text interface if you wanted. It would be better if you could get the implemented part of the user interface where you can actually click. But before you even implement the graphics on the screen, you can implement your player behind the scenes using the data and showing the variable, which is I have up here. And that's actually how I did it, and that's why I have the interface from 1 through 9. So I want to play in 5 because that's the middle square, and that's where it's always best to play first. And it draws my little X. And I want to note that that X I implemented through a costume, rather than just drawing an X every time, so it just goes and stamps a costume there. And it stamps an O costume for where the computer played. Let's play in 2. The computer did not play the appropriate move back, so we're going to play in 8, and we should win. And it has to check on it, and then it says, congratulations, X, for winning. And then you can play again if you want by clicking on the flag. Have fun working on this lab. I think you can make it a really enjoyable and fun learning experience.